Good morning, students and my teacher friends. Today's our topic of discussion is Kelvin cycle. Okay, there are some other names for Kelvin cycle. Kelvin cycle is also known as C3 pathway or dark reaction or biosynthetic phase, also known as chemosynthetic phase, or known as Kelvin-Benson-Bahrman cycle, or also known as light independent reaction. Because in C3 pathway, light is not important, it is not taking part. That's why it is also known as light independent reaction. Now, who discovered this dark reaction or C3 pathway? So, between 1946 and 1953, there were three scientists, Melvin Kelvin, James Bahrman, and Andrew Benson. These three scientists were working on Kelvin cycle. Okay, so from the name of the scientist Melvin Kelvin, this pathway is also known as Kelvin cycle. Okay, now to study this, we will divide Kelvin cycle into three phases. Okay, the first phase is carboxylation. Now, before we move on to the carboxylation, I would like to explain what is the use of Kelvin cycle, why this cycle is important. See, what happens in light reaction, NADPH2 and ATPs are produced. Okay, now from atmosphere in the leaves, CO2 is entering. This CO2 from stomata via the diffusion, it reaches to chloroplast, and this CO2 enters into the stroma of chloroplast. Okay, so in stroma, the process of fixation of CO2 is taking place, and by the fixation of CO2, there is going to be production of carbohydrates, that is starch, cellulose, glucose, fructose. All these carbohydrates are produced in the stroma of chloroplast. Okay, so in this fixation, the NADPH2 and ATPs which are produced in light reaction, that are going to be used. Okay, now to study Kelvin cycle, we will divide Kelvin cycle into three phases. The first phase is known as carboxylation. Okay, now here, as you can see, the reaction starts with RUBP, ribulose biphosphate, 6 molecule of RUBP. Now the enzyme act upon RUBP is RUBP carboxylase, ribulose biphosphate carboxylase. So RUBP carboxylase enzyme works on 6 molecules of RUBP. So 6 molecule of RUBP are converted into 6 molecule of imidazolate. Okay, so now RUBP, 6 molecule of RUBP are converted into 6 molecule of imidazolate. Now this 6 molecule of imidazolate attacks on CO2, and it is a nucleophilic attack. So imidazolate attacks on 6 molecule of CO2, and then this imidazolate is converted into 6 molecule of beta keto acid. Okay, now this beta keto acid is also known as 2-carboxy-3-keto-ribitol-1,5-biphosphate. Okay, now this beta keto acid, 6 molecule of beta keto acid combined with water molecule, 6 water molecule. Okay, so now there is a production of 6 molecule of this intermediate compound. Okay, so now we are having 6 molecule of intermediate compound. Now this intermediate compound dissociates into 6 plus 6. Okay, so 6 plus 6, that is equal to 12. So 12-3-PG. So 12 molecule of phosphoglyceric acid are produced. Okay, so in carboxylation, the thing that you have to remember is 6 molecule of RUBP are converted into 12 molecule of phosphoglyceric acid. Okay, now for your exam, this reaction are for only for our understanding. You don't have to remember this structures. Okay, now to convert 6 molecule of RBP into 12 molecule of 3PG, the enzyme responsible is RBP carboxylase. Now the full form of this enzyme is ribulose biphosphate carboxylase, that is Rubisco. Okay, now this Rubisco enzyme is the most abundant protein on the earth. Okay, now it comprises about 16% of chloroplast protein. So whatever the protein it present in chloroplast, 16% protein is Rubisco enzyme. Now location of this enzyme, where this Rubisco is located. So the enzyme is located on the outer surface of thylakoid membrane. Okay, so in Calvin cycle, with this we have completed the first phase, that is carboxylation phase. Okay, now we are starting second phase of Calvin cycle. This second phase is known as glycolytic reversal, or also known as synthesis of carbohydrate. Now we are having 12 molecule of 3-phosphoglyceric acid. So we will phosphorylate this 12 molecule of phosphoglyceric acid. Okay, so here 12 molecule of phosphoglyceric acid plus 12 ATP. Okay, so what we will do is we will remove this phosphate from ATP and we will add over here. Instead of this H, we will add P over here. Okay, now the enzyme responsible for this phosphorylation reaction is phosphoglycerokinase. So this 3-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid. Since we are having 12 molecule of 3-phosphoglyceric acid, so 12 molecule of 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid are produced. Now this is the first step. Now we are moving to second step. Now the second step reaction is known as reduction of 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid. So we are having 12 molecule of 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid plus 12 NADPH plus 12 H plus. Okay, so we will remove this O and P, okay, and we will add this hydrogen over here. So this becomes CHO. Okay, now enzyme responsible for this reduction is triose phosphate dehydrogenase. So we have converted 12 molecule of 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid into 12 molecule of phosphoglyceraldehyde. So at this point we are having 12 molecule of phosphoglyceraldehyde. Now this 12 molecule of phosphoglyceraldehyde we can write like this way: 10 pgl plus 2 pgl. Okay, so 10 plus 2 is equal to 12. Okay, now this 10 pgl we are going to use this strand 10 pgl into production of RUBP. So RUBP were used in the initial stage of the reaction and again we are producing it. So six molecule of RUBP are produced. So that's why this reaction is known as regeneration. Okay, regeneration of RUBP, and in the structure of RUBP 5 carbon are present. Okay, so the third phase of Calvin cycle is known as the regeneration phase of RUBP for RUBP. Okay, now we are left with 2 pgl. Okay, so from this 2 pgl 1 pgl is converted into DHAP. Okay, so here as you can see, this is phosphoglyceraldehyde and phosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into DHAP. Okay, so and the enzyme responsible for this reaction, so PGL is converted into DHAP, enzyme responsible is triose phosphate isomerase. Okay, so one PGL we will keep it as such, and one PGL is converted into DHAP. Okay, so now here you can see this is phosphoglyceraldehyde and this is DHAP. So we will combine these two triose sugar, and the enzyme responsible for this reaction is aldolase. Okay, so this three carbon, the new sugar that is formed is fructose 1,6 biphosphate. So in the structure of fructose 1,6 biphosphate, there's a first position and on sixth position phosphate is present. So fructose 1,6 biphosphate is formed. Okay, now so this is the step 4. Now step 5. Now this fructose 1,6 biphosphate is converted into fructose 6 phosphate. Okay, now ADP, we will remove this phosphate, and this phosphate is accepted by ADP. So ADP is converted into ATP. Okay, so when there is a production of ADP, that is dephosphorylation reaction. So we can say fructose 1,6 biphosphate is dephosphorylated to fructose 6 phosphate. Now this fructose 6 phosphate is converted into its isomer, glucose 6 phosphate. Okay, now again dephosphorylation takes place, we will remove this phosphate, and this phosphate is accepted by ADP. So ADP plus PI, so again there is a formation of ADP. So glucose 6 phosphate is converted into glucose. So with this we have completed the second phase, or the second phase is known as synthesis of carbohydrate. And as you can see, at the end of reaction the carbohydrate that is produced is glucose. So it is not that the only the glucose is produced in Kelvin cycle. Instead of glucose, sucrose can be produced, starch can be produced, cellulose can be produced. That's why this phase is known as synthesis of carbohydrate. Or all the reactions are taking place in the reverse order of glycolysis. So that's why this phase is known as glycolytic reversal. Okay, now the entire process of Kelvin cycle we can show it in the chart form. So here I have drawn the chart of Kelvin cycle. Okay, you can whatever we have discussed, okay, same thing is written over here. And on the right hand side this way, this is the net reaction of Kelvin cycle. Okay, so this is the net reaction of Kelvin cycle. So with this we have completed the topic of Kelvin cycle. My name is Manish Koshti sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Namaste.